Welcome to this video. In this video, we are solving question from GATE 2020 electronics, and this was a MCQ question. So basically, the GATE 2022 paper was very easy. It was basically based on concepts. So, and this question is a very very good question from signals and systems. So we are given a signal x of t equal to t upon 1 plus t square whole square. 1 plus t square whole square. This is the signal. And we have to find its Fourier transform. We are given x of t is equal to t upon 1 plus t square whole square, and we have to find its Fourier transform. So obviously t denotes time domain and omega here denotes frequency domain. So we have to use the properties of Fourier transform to find this value. So first of all, we are given e to the power minus mod of omega, and we have the formula for e to the power minus mod of t. So first of all, I will write the formula for e to the power minus mod of t. See, e to the power minus a mod of t is given as, its Fourier transform is given as 2a upon a square plus omega square. Okay, so e to the power minus a mod of t, the Fourier transform is given as 2a upon a square plus omega square. Now, if we replace a with 1, so e to the power minus mod of t, 2a upon 1 plus omega square. So by replacing a with 1, we got this as the answer. Now we have the e to the power minus mod of t is here. But here e to the power minus omega is here. So now I am clear that I will have to use duality property somewhere in this question. Because here it is minus mod of t and here it is e to the power minus mod of omega. So just by this step now it is clear that we have to use the duality property. Also, omega is in multiply. So if we use the if we think backwards, then we have to take it as t in multiply and then use the duality property. So the t is in multiply is in frequency domain. That is the property for differentiation in frequency domain. So I am writing the property t x t Fourier transform is j d by d omega x of j omega, where x of j omega is the Fourier transform. Where x of j omega is the Fourier transform for x of t. Okay, so if we multiply t with x of t, then we get j d by d omega x of j omega. So we have to differentiate this part and multiply it with j if we multiply this x of t with t. So this is the differentiation in frequency domain property. And I will also write the differentiation in time domain property for you, just for your revision. So the differentiation in time domain. So d by dt x of t. The differentiation in time domain is given as j of omega x of j omega. But we do not have to use the differentiation in time domain property here. So if we multiply this with t, then what we get is t e to the power minus mod of t. J, and we have to differentiate this term. So if we differentiate this term, then we get 1 plus omega square whole square 2, and differentiation for omega square is minus 2 omega. So this will be 2 into 2, 4, so minus 4 j omega. So we can write it as minus 4 j omega. So this is the Fourier transform for t e to the power minus mod of t, Fourier transform. Okay, now we will have to use the duality property. So what does the duality property say? See, the duality property says that if the x of j omega is the Fourier transform of x of t, then if we replace omega with t, so we will get x of t. So this is the capital X, this is also the capital X. So it is denoting that we have replaced omega with t. So we will get 2 pi x of minus omega. So we will have to multiply this term with 2 pi and replace t with minus of omega. So if we use the duality property here, then what we will get? So I am removing this term. So if we use the duality property here, then what we will get? So replace omega with t. So minus 4 j t upon 1 plus t square whole square. See, we have in denominator we have got 1 plus t square whole square. That is what we wanted. So that will be Fourier transform, or this will be 2 pi t. Sorry, replace t with minus of omega. So minus of omega and e to the power minus of, again replace t with minus of omega. So e to the power minus of mod of minus omega. So mod of minus omega is obviously omega. So e to the power mod of minus omega is obviously mod of omega. So e to the power minus mod of omega. So if you find this minus and this minus will get cancelled, then this 2 will divide this 4 with 2. So we will get t e to the power t upon Fourier transform in here. So t upon 1 plus t square whole square Fourier transform is pi omega e to the power minus mod of omega upon 2j. So if you see the options, then option A is correct. Option A is correct. So in this way we can easily solve this question. Just we have to use the properties according to the question. So first e to the power minus mod of omega was given. So we use the property e to the power minus a of mod of t, and then obviously mod of omega was given, so we knew that we had to use a duality property. So in this way we can solve the question. Just we have to remember the properties. So basically a 2022 paper was very very easy, and if you knew the concepts, then you can easily solve all the questions. So thank you, and if you have any doubts or any feedback, then please post your comment in the comment box. Please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you and best of luck.